Welcome to Phoenix Raceway, where today the action isn't just on the track, but also right next door here on the lanes. Pro Bowling's very best turned out to kick off PBA All-Star Weekend with a unique contest that will test every aspect of their game, including some mind-bending trick shots. It's the PBA All-Star Skills Showdown on FS1. Welcome to the barn at Jason Phoenix Raceway for an unbelievable evening of professional bowling. It's the PBA's All-Star Weekend. And tonight, you'll see the PBA All-Star Skills Showdown. Tomorrow on FS1, the Legacy Cup with legends and rising stars. And on Fox Sunday, 1 Eastern Time, the Go Bowling PBA NASCAR Invitational with NASCAR drivers joining PBA and PWBA stars. And stars, we've got them tonight because we have a unique format here. It's a team competition among manufacturers. Team Brunswick, Bill O'Neill in charge of that bunch. Kyle Troop, your U.S. Open champion. And, of course, O'Neill, a major winner. And on Team Motive, E.J. Tackett. Oh, look, he made another TV show. And hello again, everybody, with Hall of Famer Randy Peterson and Kimberly Pressler. I am Dave Lamont. We were talking before the show. You've never seen anything like this, have you?
I haven't. I've been around for a while, as you know, Dave. But this is going to be a spectacular competition. And what better way to kick it off than with the Skills Challenge tonight? You know, we've got five legends that are on tap here with us. We're going to be talking to throughout the telecast. And then we've got three of the top stars on tour today that will be competing. Three different types of formats: a strike contest, a spare contest, and then a trick shot contest. It's going to be a fantastic evening of bowling.
And the trick shot contest is being judged by those legends. That's got to be a little intimidating.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, you want to talk about the Mount Rushmore bowling, we have it here tonight.
All right, so here's the strike contest. This is what's going to start this thing off. It's a five-frame match. Only strikes matter. You're not going to see a spare shot in this baby. In the first round, the top two will advance. In the second round, it's a five-frame match. Again, only strikes are going to count. And if there's a tie in the round decided by a one ball, you've got a strike roll-off. So we're going to get one team knocked out in just five frames before we determine who's going to take the lead. There are points awarded first, second, and third. And so we're going to be accumulating those points throughout the evening. Kimberly Pressler is standing by with our strike competitors right now.
Thanks, Dave. So you guys are part of the strike contest. So I got to ask you, Packy, this should be pretty easy for you, right? Because that's all you guys do is strike all day.
I don't know about easy. I'm just hoping to get more than one.
Well, Kyle, he's hoping to get more than one, so I'm going to put you on the spot. How many are you going to get?
I think a nice, juicy ham bone will be good. So we're going to go with four strikes, Kimberly.
EJ, I might as well just go ahead and ask you the same thing. Are you ready to beat these two, outstrike them?
I mean, I always show up, and I try to be ready every single time, so we're going to see what's going to happen.
All right, good luck to you guys.
All right, let's go down to the floor and talk with Norm Duke. Norm, you're sitting amongst some pretty good company down there, and, this is the strike contest. You're no stranger to throwing strikes. Who do you like in this contest?
Well, I'll tell you what, you got to pick the person that is striking the most here recently. I got to pick the Troop. Plus, look at that hair. You know, I started for 30 years with Voss, and now we got Troop. God, I love that.
Yeah, Norm, you and I never had hair like that ever.
No.
Thanks, Norm.
Oh, no.
And the beauty of the evening is that Randy will have ability to talk to all five of those incredible Hall of Famers. 188 titles on the PBA Tour and 36 majors.
Yeah, that's a lot. Five of the greatest ever.
And that's not counting PBA 50. That's not counting the multiple regional titles.
I mean, the late, great Mark Roth, the late Earl Anthony. You'd have to squeeze them in.
Oh, yeah.
And then your dais is complete.
Five frames. Becky Hanrahan gets a trip 10 for the two-handed lefty. Now, the way the points break down here, by the way.
And that is absolutely why we should not have been doing that. Because
25 when your team wins a particular competition, 20 for second, and then 10 for third. So we're going to be adding those points up as the evening goes on. Remember, no spares in this contest. Oh, a chef's kiss he just gave back there.
Is that what that was?
That's a little, wow, my dinner is just perfect. Look at this.
Kyle's bowling great this season, already with two wins in a major. Speaking of bowling great this year, how about this guy?
Are we allowed to have TV without EJ attacking anymore?
No, we're not.
Uh-oh.
The bucket.
Well, you know, that might be happening later in the spare contest.
It actually is.
And we'll reveal the spares gradually as the evening goes on. But, that's a nothing for motive on that one. 43-foot LBC pattern. Randy will get into the particulars of that in a little bit.
Wrong part of the song.
Packy with a couple of titles. He'll be defending Roth Holman with Mitch Huppe as part of the World Series. Second time around for Packy.
Oh. Yuck. I watched him in practice, and Dave, he threw a lot of strikes in practice, and going in, I thought maybe he'd be the favorite because he's the only southpaw. Almost a 7-10, but it's not a strike, and all we care about in this competition is strikes.
That's a little light, and Messenger's not going to get there. So it opens the door for E.J. Tackett to make it a three-way tie.
You were right. It's a tight lane.
We're in a building called the Barn, and just not very far away, just a few hundred feet, would be the Phoenix Raceway track itself. We're tied.
I can't remember the last time I saw EJ throw a pink ball.
Hey, I stole one.
That beautiful arm swing that goes out and then back in, tucks underneath him. And then the incredible power of a man of that size.
Yeah, it's staggering what he can do.
Tremendous athlete.
All right, third frame. Oh my, indeed. Well, the striking.
That's not now. Did you bring a ball that would, I would say,
hooks?
How do I categorize this? Hooks more than that one.
I brought a couple of them.
There will be, Randy, some friendly trash talk. Or maybe not so friendly.
Yeah, right.
Gotta go.
Whoa. What is going on?
EJ Tackett could take the lead.
All right, everybody's got six at least once.
Someone explain the format again.
Somebody explain the format again. Yeah, that was a good one. I don't think we have to do a whole lot for these shows. I think the players got it together.
EJ Tackett and Motor take the lead.
Yeah, he missed
about his lift. See his teammates, Tom Smallwood.
I'm missing a head pin again.
And Sam Cooley. Tom will be in the spare competition. Sam will be the trick shot artist. So only two frames going to be bowled before we knock somebody to the curb here. Oh, that looks solid, Randy.
All right, the good news is we only need one more to beat what you said on interview.
Yeah. Actually.
Oh, you've got some premier trash talkers, Tommy Jones and Bill O'Neill, his own teammate.
When it comes to trash talking, Tommy Jones is a varsity.
Perfect from Kyle. That puts Becky in an uncomfortable position right now.
Hey, yeah. Don't stop the party. I don't really know the words.
Reigning player of the year, EJ Tackett. Got a hook. Oh my goodness. How about the helicopter action on the seven?
Well, he's through. He's already into the next round.
Yep.
And this is absolute must strike for Packy to have a chance. Otherwise, he will be eliminated, and Brunswick will be third and pick up 10 points in the team competition. And he Tackett's going to be in third place. So we know now that Kyle Troop and E.J. Tackett have advanced to the next round. The next five frames will feature those two superstars.
Well, the Randy Jinx just did in Packy.
You still got it, buddy.
Sorry, Packy. I meant what I said.
That's okay, Kyle. He is through. Tackett and Troop have made it through to the next round. EJ's going to get one more just for fun in this five-frame match.
The guy that started off with the bucket.
Yeah.
Leads the fifth frame. And he'll be number one against Troop. Oh, five more. Wow.
Hey, I barely got 10 on the two shots I didn't strike.
No pressure on that shot for E.J. Tackett, but a little bit of heat will be turned up when there's five more frames coming. 25 points will be awarded to the winning team. Will it be motive or will it be storm? Well, we all remember it. It is arguably the biggest strike in the sports history. U.S. Open Championship, a record for PDW, his fifth U.S. Open title. Who can ever forget that?
Hey, Pete, we just watched probably one of the most infamous strikes in the history of the PBA Tour, and you threw it to win your fifth U.S. Open. What was it like? What did you feel after all 10 went down with that shot?
You know, Randy, it was like I asked for a re-rack right before the shot. And right after that, it probably the calmest I've ever been throwing a shot. You know, for a U.S. Open title, being very calm, that was so cool to throw the strike and win. And, you know, hats off to Mike Fagan, too.
Thanks, Pete. I know we all enjoyed that.
You could say that.
I mean, my goodness, what a telecast that was. Take a look at our 43-foot LBC oil pattern. Players are going to be in, feeding it to the track to the right and left on both sides of the lane. Follow the transition. I don't think there's going to be a whole lot of that, but E.J. Tackett seems to be fairly well dialed in, even though his last shot got five, but we're down to two. E.J. Tackett and Kyle Troop.
10 points for Brunswick, 25 for the winner of this, and 20 for second place. Competition between the manufacturers, making this just a little extra spice. Through the nose for Tackett. Quick reminder, we're not going to see any spare shooting. Not in this competition.
No.
That's the next one.
Points, son. Get them points.
Made sure I didn't get six.
Tackett remarking as we went to break that his two of his shots barely added up to 10 as opposed to the three strikes he had.
Kyle Troop's going to make a ball change here and look for a little different shape.
Oh, perfect.
Yeah, he's going to more hook.
Remember, these lanes have not seen any action other than a warm-up, too, so these are still fairly fresh to the players as well.
Yep. I don't think Kyle liked his reaction with the other ball, obviously, so he goes to something stronger and moves in. He's going to shape it. Freaking shape for nine. Oh!
Really?
Wow.
Well, watch the ball. It's going to go right by the nine pin. Thank you very little.
Tackett the tie. And he needed two messengers, which would have been really wild to watch that.
Ah, I actually threw that one good, though.
In case there is a tie, there will be a one ball roll off, which of course you got to strike. attack, and once again, trying to tie. This is his third frame already, though. That looks pretty good. Now you saw that time the ball kicking out the nine.
Yeah, it actually took the nine out.
Great shot.
That was a little really better.
That was too really awesome.
So Kyle to take the lead here. And of course, it wasn't that long ago that Kyle picked up the U.S. Open Championship. Gotta go. Oh, no problem at all.
Yeah, now he can shut out EJ with one more.
Hey, good ball change.
It sounds like somebody tipped him off.
So if he strikes here, he has a chance to shut EJ out with one more after it. EJ is maxed out at three. Troop can max out with four.
Yeah, he's going to put Tackett in a position where he must strike to keep this going. Otherwise, Storm will take the first 25 points. Getting love from the legends. So the math is very simple here as we watch this beautiful strike. This Just Right strike brought to you by Just Bear, the mindful choice for high quality protein with no antibiotics ever. Just Right, Just Bear.
And the six just barely kicked the 10 out, but EJ has to strike to have a chance. It needs the next.
Been in the position before.
Yeah, a lot.
Should I ice you and get a re-rack or?
You get two a game.
Oh, I get two a game still.
Yeah. Oh, that's funny. A re-rack.
Hey, that's all I need.
That's fair.
Well, it's very simple. If he doesn't strike, it's a victory for Team Storm.
Yeah.
If he does, off we go to settle a champion in this event.
He did what he could. Now it's up to Troop. Troop's last shot. If he strikes, this first win will go to Team Storm. If he doesn't strike, we'll go to a roll-off. Just inside a fourth arrow. Kicks the 10 out nicely. Great job by EJ Tackett. Now Troop for the win.
For Storm.
Let's go. Good shot, dude.
What a beauty there by Kyle Troop for the win. He's been doing it all of 2024. Wow.
The juicy ham bone. That was for you, Kimberly.
Beauty.
Yeah, four strikes.
Well, somebody suggested the ball change. I don't know if it was Rash or Tang, but they gave him the proper advice. But it's still up to the bowler to execute, and hardly anybody in the world executing any better right now than Kyle Troop. And Kimberly, you've got him.
Well, Kyle, you called it at the top of the show. You were going to get a ham bone, and look at that right there.
Yeah, I mean, Darren said it looks like somebody just took a little bite out of the ham bone since they weren't four in a row, but you know, I knew EJ was going to make it tough there. Feels good to get the strike for the team, get us a good start in this cup.
Yep, congratulations. Ms. Storm is now ahead, heading into the next competition.
All right, let's go, boys.
Spares will be next. The antithesis of what we just witnessed is about to happen because Darren Tang representing Team Storm against Tom Smallwood for Motive and Bill O'Neill, the real deal for Brunswick, coming up. Well, Randy, we just honored PDW for one great strike that won the U.S. Open. How about a bunch of great strikes to clinch a tournament in the 10th?
What a great match this was. David Ozio against Mike Albee. Ozio striking out in the 10th frame to shoot 279 to force Mike Albee to strike first ball in the 10th. He's got the front nine. Make it the front 10. That's for the win. But his work's not done yet. That's 11. And there you have it, right there. 11 in a row. Albee for perfection.
Albee for 10,000 extra bucks in the bank account as well. You notice he walked away? He started to walk that shot out. A very confident man he was.
Mike, we just got a great look at that memorable 300 game against David Ozio. What do you remember most about that afternoon?
Well, it was just a wonderful day. Obviously, it's something you could dream about. But, David Ozio obviously pushed all the way to the end. And, to get that first one, actually 11th and 12th were pretty easy compared to that 10th one. But, just a fun day and just love to watch it every time.
That's spectacular. Congratulations on a great career, Mike, and thanks so much for being here with us.
It's awesome to be here, Randy. Thank you. And to be with these four guys and the current pros, it's a wonderful time for me. Thank you.
Yeah, what a great thrill having Mike here as well as those other Hall of Famers. So Storm picked up 25, Motive 20, and Brunswick 10. That's pretty good. But now there's going to be incredible point values for the spares we're going to see. So we're taking strikes right out of the equation. Kimberly Pressler is standing by with our spare experts.
That's right, David. So everything right now is all about spares. So, Darren, I got to ask you, how's your spare game right now?
Good.
Does it need to be great for this next part?
We'll see.
All right, Tom, I got to ask you, let's be honest, did you practice your spares before coming into today?
No. I mean, for the last, 6 weeks, yeah. But apparently didn't go very good. So I'm here at Process Elimination. No one strikes more than EJ, so he had to do the strike thing. I have zero trick shots. I barely make spares. But, yes, that's why I'm here.
Well, by process of elimination, does that mean, Bill, you're going to be the winner here?
I mean, it seems that way. I mean, we've definitely established this year on tour that multi-pin spare conversion is my thing. So we should be all right today.
All right. Good luck to you all.
Yes. A U.S. Open reference, if ever there was one. So the bucket gets you 25 points. Also getting 25 points, the old picket fence, the 1-2-4-7. Not an easy one to shoot. Then for 50 points, the baby split, a 4-5, a washout, a 1-2-4-10 for 50. And then for 100, something you don't see pros shoot at that often.
No.
To 5-7. And should we be tied, the old 4-9 split will be the roll-off.
Yeah, there we go. You got to get that back pin, the 8-pin. That's the key. Most players will throw a hook into that spare to cover that back pin. Norm Duke, sitting with us tonight, he always threw it straight at the bucket. And he was one of the best spare shooters ever.
Well, you've got, I mean, listen, you can't survive in the sport if you can't make spares. And all five of those guys that are over there, incredible spare shooters. So we'll see if Darren Tang is indeed right. He gets straight at it.
Yeah.
Out of the Duke playbook.
There you go.
Look at this guy. He's trying to play mind games. No.
I wonder if Norm gave him some coaching earlier.
Wouldn't be surprised.
Can I squeeze it a little bit, maybe?
Because I'm kind of with you. I always think of that as when you have to hit a pocket.
Yeah, I mean, especially when the old pattern's a little bit softer, you can go ahead and hook into it like that.
All right. Is that possible to throw Brooklyn on the bucket?
Yeah, well, never I'll go with that. But he crossed over so far that he was able to get the 8-pin out. Watch the 4-pin. 4-pin clips the 8 and covers it.
You only get one crack at this, by the way. And
that's more the traditional way to make it. Three bowlers, three different ways. Two tried to hook it. Darren Tang threw it straight. And we'll move on to our next combination. It's the picket fence.
So each player picked up 25 points for their team.
I agree.
That way, or you can try to cut the head pin into the other three. I don't recommend that way. Cover all four with the ball.
Yeah, that's a tough way to do it.
Here goes everything.
So Darren Tang, again, this is a 25-point spare.
Got a hook.
No, sir. No 25 for Tang and for Team Storm.
We shoot that one a lot on tour.
Yeah, this is a good time to throw Brooklyn.
We saw Tom hook. Can't imagine that's going to happen again here. That looks good.
That's how you do it. All four with the ball.
Textbook. Textbook for Smallwood. 25 for your motive.
I don't ever know anything. I never know. You get through it, I said.
1, 2, 4, and 7.
I'm shooting all spares. Oh,
God.
Uh-oh. Michael Lucky.
Yeah, that was the second option. And that's not the one tonight. I don't think Bill tried to go with that. But it works out for him.
All right.
It's not really called the baby
split. It's like, uh-oh, it's not going to hook
enough. I was aiming the other side, but I wasn't.
Hey, both sides
were. You'll never know what I was aiming for. You'll just know.
Two. So we're good.
So here's the 4-5.
Bring it home, Sam.
43%, Randy.
Yeah, we get those numbers from our great friends at Lane Talk. For more information, go to lanetalk.com or download their free app.
Amateurs, according to PBA LBC League stats, with a combined 176 average in 4,000 games, make this one just 23% of the time.
That's a chance. Nicely done.
Good luck, boys.
Darren Tang making it look easy on the 4-5.
Well, that's 50 points for Storm.
I had no clue that was.
1 left.
Yep. Yeah. Ready for the senior tour.
They might call this the baby split, the 4-5. I never called it that because it was way harder than the 3-10.
3-10, yeah. Pros generally do very well with a 3-10 or 2-7. The real deal.
Perfect. Oh, nicely done.
Right down the middle. Come on now. Come on now.
So that is 50 for Brunswick. And the next one coming up, the washout, is also worth 50. It's a win for fans and a win for football as the USFL and the XFL merger is official. The United Football League will begin play March 30th with the USFL champion Birmingham Stallions taking on the XFL champs, the Arlington Renegades. The United Football League this spring on ABC, ESPN, Fox, and FS1. Spring just got stronger. That will be fun. A lot of laughs, yeah, having a good time so far, but yet at the same time, there's some serious competition here between these three manufacturers and their outstanding reps. More spares coming up, and they get tougher as we go on, and the point values get even higher, including a 100-point split conversion that may decide the winner. Four times, Randy, the 7-10's been made on TV, but only once in history.
Yeah, one time in history, Big Four.
Incredible.
The man
himself is standing by to talk to you.
And the great Walter A. joining us, the winningest player in the history of the sport. And Walter A., we just got done talking about, you know, the 7-10's been made four times on television, but the Big Four only once by you. What was that afternoon like?
Well, that was a fun afternoon, except for I got beat by 20 pins, so that wasn't so fun. Everybody's like, oh, that was an awesome spare. Like, I lost by 20 pins. So, yeah.
Well, that's why he has won more than anybody else.
Well, I'll tell you what a career. And
still
the longevity of his career and what he's done to the sport for so many years. And he's still winning.
He's still winning.
Yeah. All right.
So we have two to go. Washout. This is not fun to look at.
Yeah, typically you want to try to make this by cutting the head pin over into the 10. Anything else would be futile.
I'll keep you on your toes.
Anything else would be uncivilized.
That too.
All right.
So Darren Tang, 75 points so far. The winning team will pick up 25.
Bam. Oh, my.
Wow.
He's good at that straight ball.
There was no messing around with that.
He makes the bucket, throwing it straight.
Did he line me up down when I got there straight?
Commercial break. Yep.
And he throws it straight at the washout, makes that. Curves it into the 4-5, makes that.
Look out. No.
Smalls tried to hook it into that.
We got loose. I got loose too hard.
Is anyone going to pull a Simonson and throw a backup ball into it?
I don't think so.
What would Norm do? He would throw a backup ball. I can't do that.
Good call, Dave. Good call.
Norm, that's what Norm would do.
Now, is Billy going to shoot it from the right or from the left?
Tommy told me to hook it.
He's going from the right side of the lane. We're pretty straight much straight in. On it.
Oh, yeah. No.
Missed it.
Wow. Yeah. That is a big W for Storm right there. That's 50 points that Brunswick and Motive don't get.
I mean, I think the more angle you use to shoot that, the bigger your margin for error is.
Come on.
And still to come this weekend, the action continues on PBA All-Star Weekend with the PBA Legacy Cup. Legends and Rising Stars, who won Eastern on FS1, some of your very favorites of all time getting together. And then Sunday, the Go Bowling PBA NASCAR Invitational, 1 Eastern time on Fox, also streaming on the Fox Sports app.
Well, don't look now, but Team Storm's got the lead, and right now you're just going to try to cut the 5 into the 7, just get enough of it right here and slide it on over.
So it's Storm with the advantage right now, 125, Brunswick 100, Motive 50, but this is 100 points
Darren.
Right here.
Yep, Darren can lock it up for Team Storm right here.
Pros only make this 23% of the time, amateurs 11.
Curving it.
That's pretty good.
Left the door open.
Pretty good.
Wide open.
Thank you.
I like the attempt, though. I think it's better to move in and try to hook it at this.
Now, Smallwood at 50 points would go past Tang if he makes it.
Yep.
So it's going to be third place for Motive here. They'll pick up 10 points. They'll have 30 total. Right now, Bill O'Neill can give Brunswick 25 points in their pocket if he converts this.
Be careful on this right lane. You get it too far to the right, it's not going to hook. Excuse me, left lane.
Got it. Oh, no! I thought he had it. He got too much of the 5-pin. Nobody converts it. So Storm ends up winning the spare competition. 125 to 100 over Brunswick with Motive third with 50. So Storm... 50 points for the team so far. Motive with 40 and Brunswick with 20.
The Storm guys are over here celebrating, Darren. And did you totally downplay your spare game? Because I think you did.
I don't know if it was downplaying. I think it was more up to perception.
Well, you were making it look kind of easy out there. How was this competition for you?
I think it was really tricky because some of the spares we decided to hook. I also had Tommy Jones in the back trying to tell me what to do, playing some of the mind games, so shout out to him. But yeah, it was fun.
Thank you, Derek.
So this ends up being the conqueror right there. Perfect. I've actually seen guys do a ringing head pin.
Yes.
Going around the 10.
Yeah, if you cut it just right, you can sling the head pin around the 10. Darren was just a little bit left of that spot, so he was able to sling the head pin into the 10 pin and cover it nicely.
The Storm off to a fast start, winning strikes and spares. Brunswick and Motive changing positions. This time Brunswick second, Motive third in the spare competition. We have trick shots yet to come. That is going to be wild. Now, we have a lot of talent here, a lot of skills. We know how great these folks are on the lanes. But what about some of the skills that our PBA pros want to learn? Well, that is the subject of today's Pressing Questions with Kimberly Pressler, presented by Go Bowling.
Tommy, what skill or talent would you like to learn?
Two-handed bowling. Seems to be much easier for like Belmo. I don't think he's better. I just think he cheats.
Have you not tried two-handed?
I have. I can't do it.
What skill or talent would I like to learn? Probably to cook a little better. I'm not a very good cook.
Well, I've played golf for about 40 years now, and I have no skill and no talent. So I'd really like to learn that game.
And learn how to drive.
You don't know how to drive?
My girlfriend would tell me otherwise.
Chris, is there a skill or a talent that you'd like to learn?
I'd love to be able to sing.
You can't carry a tune?
I sound like Kermit even when I sing.
You know, I've been thinking about this recently. I want to learn how to play an instrument. I don't know, guitar maybe? Maybe harmonica is something I could take. That wasn't good. Something I can take with me on the road.
Guitar would be awesome. I would like to learn guitar.
I wish I could speak a couple different languages.
Italian sounds really fun to learn. And I love Italy. And I could go just travel all over Italy and just hang out and pretend I'm Italian.
Yeah, I would definitely like to learn at least a couple different languages, but I struggle enough with English.
Hey, Tom, so do we. Sam Cooley, trick shot man for Motive. But you know who the real king of the trick shots is who's in the building today? Norm Duke. He'll be watching these three competitors, the Hall of Famer Tommy Jones and Sean Rash, judging them, because nobody did it better than that man. You know, you can have a lot of debates about who's the greatest this, who's the greatest that. I'm not sure you can have a debate about who's the greatest bowling trick shot artist. Unless it's Andy Garapapa, of course, going way back. But in the modern times, here's your maestro right there.
Yeah, I mean, we had a lot of really good trick shot artists. Parker Bone III was a good one, but I'm not sure there was one better than this guy.
That one's pretty good.
Because, wait for it. Yeah. You got to have a lot of imagination, a lot of confidence, and a lot of talent.
Yeah, Norm, you know, when most of us were practicing trying to strike, you somehow found some time to do these trick shots, and you were probably the best at it. Do you have a favorite? I mean, do you have one that when you go and do your exhibitions around the world, you just pull it out and you go, hey, watch this?
Yeah, my favorite is definitely the towel shot. Even though it's not the hardest that I've selected, that one there that you just saw was really hard. But the towel shot's kind of like a signature move of mine, and fans enjoy it, so I keep giving it to them.
Thank you, Norm.
Will anybody dare try that tonight in front of Norm? Let's find out what the rules are here first, because you see that rather intimidating group with 38 major championships among them. You got 5 minutes to perform one or more trick shots. You see the judges, they're going to be holding up rating cards, and the highest cumulative score will win. The tie for first will be broken by a one-trick roll-off. 188 PBA titles judging you.
Yeah. Just so you know, Mike Albee held up 10 after he saw Norm Duke's trick shot.
As well he should.
Yeah.
Registration for the 2024 PBA LBC National Championships is now open to bowlers of all skill levels and from all centers. The PBA LBC National Championship is heading to a new location outside Chicago and includes two junior divisions, and those are new. You can compete in singles as well as optional doubles and team events. Even combine your scores with the pros. Enter today at pba.com/LBC tournaments. Randy Peterson, Dave Lamont, you just saw Kimberly Pressler, and we have Sam Cooley repping Motive here. The chair trick. Looks like, is that going to be first? Now, the clock is already running. We're 30 seconds into this. As you can see, there's the clock. 5 minutes, and you can do as many trick shots as you want.
This is going to be a worry.
Even that, I think, is pretty impressive.
That's not bad for first
attempt. Well, I watched Osku Palermo do that strike. And this is going back a few years. And, I mean, we were all, like, jaw-dropped watching Osku throw it 20 feet in the air halfway down the lane.
And try one more.
You got it.
I'm getting worse as I go. I think that's... Yeah, I'll definitely hit the chair then. I think I'm going to have to retire that one. That's not very good.
Yeah, why don't you put somebody in the chair? Two balls to the 7-10. No. You remember when you and I did that?
That's still not bad for my first
attempt. I do.
Somebody made a pretty funny video about that, too.
You threw the first shot, and then you...
I need your help!
You gave me the little arch so I could throw between your legs, and we covered it.
And then acted like a couple of eight-year-olds when we finished. I think a judge is giving him a hard time here, Randy.
I think I should ball change on this. I might hit two balls then.
Time running out for Sam. Looks like he wants to try one more time on this one. Two balls. And hopefully now he's going to head to the channel, unfortunately.
It's like maybe I'm just watching me ball in general.
Parker, can you hear Randy? Parker.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, not a lot of good going on out there right now. What advice would you give?
He better pick something easier. Making a five pin might be a little softer than what we're doing right now.
That needs a hook.
Oh. It did? Look at that.
That was pretty good.
I did get another chance.
You got a minute left. They want to see it with one ball. Though.
One ball?
All right, two balls, and if they're going to both be on the gutter. So Sam does have the one shot that worked.
Yeah, get more this way.
The thumbless shot, and he's now down to about 40 seconds and counting.
Make it one ball.
Oh, well now.
Oh, boy. I thought he was going to make it down there in time.
Hey, Norm, is he trying to steal your thunder here with a two-ball shot?
Oh, he done.
Come back.
He got nothing. No thunder there, Randy. I'm sorry. No thunder. Out of the gutter. Come on.
Oh, it's like
time may run out on Sam Cooley. He was able to convert one shot. That was a thumbless strike with just two fingers.
You got one, four,
and time is up.
Dick.
What do you think?
I think six.
Six for effort?
You think six?
Six for effort?
Well, he didn't get one.
Six for effort.
And if it was like we could have a one here.
Tommy Jones should not be allowed in that huddle.
But you know what? Everybody can vote their own.
We're going to vote our own.
That's right.
Vote your own. All right. You're good.
All right.
In front of you.
In front of you.
I mean, that's going to be us in about 10 years. So.
All right. Team with a six.
Ready? 10.
7 is 13.
Are you still holding on to
all right, guys, what do you think? Give us some numbers. Walter A with 7. Parker, 7.
Yeah, we're going to
Mike Alvey, 6. Norm, 7. And Pete Weber, 6. Mike, why only 6?
It was a good effort. Good effort. You know, if I threw a ball that good, I might try it for my first ball on tour, but I'll tell you what. 6 for a good effort. He made some good tries, I'll say.
All right. Thanks, Mike.
Now, Kimberly standing by with Sam Cooley, who had 5 minutes. It was pretty hard.
Sam, you ended up with a 33. Be honest. Do you like that score?
It's a little bit more than I thought I was going to get.
Well, let's talk about the fact that you did get one strike. What was it, a thumbless strike?
It was basically two fingers with a straight swing back, and I had to try and hook it without using the palm of my hand. I think that was pretty good.
It was pretty good. All right, well, you start off with a 33.
Thank you, Kimberly and Sam. We have two more. Hall of Famer Tommy Jones. What tricks does he have up his sleeve? We're going to find out when we return. All right, partner, we talked quite a bit about Norm Duke's trick shot ability, but this sneaky lefty from New Jersey isn't bad either. What is this?
I don't know. There's a lot going on there.
That's the mustachio, Parker. Oh, my God. Look at his kids then, and now look at them. Kicking people's fannies and bowling is what they're doing. That is unbelievable imagination and, of course, execution.
Parker, how did you come up with that trick shot that we just saw there?
It was based on something that I seen over in Japan. I watched some guys do it, shooting a five pin, and I said it would be a lot cooler on the lane if you add a couple more balls and then add some baby splits at the other end, and it really turned over to be fantastic.
Oh, so you basically stole it from some guy in Japan.
Well, he was only shooting a five pin with it. I decided to add more elements.
All right, how long did it take you to get really good at making that?
That particular shot? Actually, not that long. The hardest part of it is lining up the front three balls. Because if the front three balls, if the last ball in line is just a little bit off, you'll miss everything at the other end.
There you have it. Thank you, Parker. Appreciate that. So the score update for Motive, represented by Sam Cooley here, 33. That's with five judges, so obviously the average. But we're finding out that this is hard to do. You've got a five-minute time limit. What will Tommy Jones do? Maybe Kimberly can get a couple of trick shots out of Tommy.
Well, Dave, I heard the rumor is that Tommy is going to be doing something pretty hard coming up here. Is that how true is that rumor?
Well, I bowled against the panel more than the rest of these guys, and I kind of know what they like. And this trick shot has been done by Chris Barnes on TV. And I'm pretty sure that if he can do it on TV, I can probably do it on TV. I think my record's a little bit better than his, even though he did beat me on TV a couple times. But yeah, we're gonna go for the gusto, try to entertain the fans here.
Well, with that really hard one, if you don't get it on the first try, is your plan to keep trying it again until you get it?
If at first you don't succeed.
All right, thank you, and good luck to you.
The PBA is proud to have Bowlers to Veterans Link as the official charity of the PBA Tour. Since 1942, with the support of the bowling community, BVL has raised more than $56 million for veterans. And to donate, go to BVL.org. And one of the gentlemen who's very much involved in that is the great Johnny Petragli, who just celebrated another birthday.
He did. Happy belated birthday, Johnny.
Yeah, he'll cash again on the PBA 50 Tour.
Yeah.
He did it in 2023. Huh? He cashed again. Unbelievable.
2-1.
He has cashed in six different decades. What is this? A pool cue. You know, I saw the pool cue used in practice, and nobody was able to strike with it, so I'm a little surprised by Tommy. Waiting on the ball return. That's eating into his time. Although he's only used 30 seconds so far.
In my bag.
That's got a chance.
Yep. Oh, that was close. That was close.
All right, one more time.
And Bill O'Neill hustling over.
One more time, we win.
Different ball to save some time. That's a smart move.
Hey, judges, am I ahead of the last guy?
Yes! Oh! And it counts!
Yeah, we're moving up. We're going to go say something.
All you had to do is change balls. Bill O'Neill, assist.
Right at it.
Change balls. Ball's going dead straight.
Oh, let's try this instead.
All right. Needs a hook. I think he got this.
Yes.
Oh no! In front.
But he doesn't know that because it's easier.
All right, one more time.
3-10.
I don't know. You may have heard Norm Duke say he doesn't know that it's easier to do it with the 3-10.
I need the pro.
There's a 7 or 8. Now he's going back.
Just for 7.
Walter Ayer, are you impressed with Tommy's attempts?
He's making good efforts. There you go.
Yeah, that's not bad. All right, he finally covered it. What'd you think of that, Walter Ayer?
Well, that last one was great. I mean, the other two were pretty close, so he nailed it on the third one, which he did on that pool shot.
Well, this one's an all-time classic.
A little hard.
seen Chris Barnes make this a few times. The Flying Eagle.
The Flying Eagle is really difficult.
Yeah, and I've seen some equipment severely damaged by trying to shoot this.
Well,
deck pin lights broken, glass shattered all over the pin deck. We've got a POV camera down lane. That could go too.
And the principle there is to take that pin that's sticking out and fly it off to the right to take out the 10 pin on the right lane. It's extraordinarily difficult.
Cut that front pin into the 10, cross lane, and then the ball deflects off into the 7.
Tommy's made two so far. Sam Cooley was only able to make one when he scored 33 points for Motive.
Maybe he is right in between where he needs to be. There's Packy Hanrahan setting up that front pin. Oh, that was close.
I put the feather on that one.
Yeah, that's the camera, too.
I'm all getting
hosed. Are you ready to write the check for the new camera if we need it?
No. Deflected and went around the 7 pin. Can you believe that?
Making Barnes look good.
The ball's not supposed to go in front of the 7.
What do you mean to do, Bill?
No, I know. I don't think.
Watch this. Unbelievable.
Yeah, I don't think I can roll it out right now.
One more try.
Wow. All but making it. That was about as close as you could get. The last two shots for Tommy Jones. And let's go to the judges.
I mean, he's the best. You and two, you
judges, what did you think about Tommy Jones's effort?
Norm, I'm on your team.
It's good efforts, I think. But I mean, the two best guys here are Norm and Parker, so I'm going with whatever they got.
Oh, Norm, stop it. That's better. You don't have a 9 in there?
Oh, I got 9s. I got a 7, too.
What I see.
All right, we'll settle out of court for 8. 7, Pete?
All right, that adds up, though, to 39. That beats Sam Cooley by 6. Kimberly standing by. Boy, that was something, Kimberly. He almost made the impossible.
Yeah, and he actually got the hard part. He got the right one lane. Did you think you were going to nail it at that point?
I definitely thought there was two of them that I had a chance to make. But, you know, it's a tricky one, so I'm going to give Barnes his props. And he did make it the first time. We're not going to tell any of these people that. I had 6 attempts at it. Didn't make any of them, so.
Well, you did get 2 tricks. And earlier you had said that you know these guys over here. You know what they like. So I got to ask, the one where you turned around and you kind of threw it under your legs, which of those judges were you trying to impress with that one?
Norm is the manager of the Dallas Strikers, so he's looked at my backside more than most. So I went over and gave him a 5 first, knowing that he appreciated that one.
And why did you pick the one with the pool stick?
That's a pretty easy one that, you know, we're just trying to make one there so we can get on the board. And, you know, the rest is pretty much history.
Well, congratulations, because Brunswick is in the lead with 39 right now.
All right, Kimberly and Tommy, thank you very much. So, Randy, over under on how many texts Barnes has sent Tommy.
Barnes is blowing up his phone right now, man. He's not going to let him let that one down.
One competitor left, and that's Sean Rash, a man who's been around the block a time or two and has seen a variety of trick shots, probably tried a few himself. What does Sean Rash have for us? What tricks will a veteran come up with? So far we've had Sam Cooley and Tommy Jones compete. And let's take a look, Randy, what the best have been from both.
I've tried this before. It's kind of tough. You got to snap your wrist real quick, no thumb in it. And you start with that flat wrist, pretty good shot there. And then TJ likes to use the pool stick and then throws it between his legs, tries a flying eagle, which Chris Barnes will never let him down, or never let him live down.
Texts are still coming in, I hear. Get a little love from the Hall of Famers, by the way, of which Tommy has won himself. So the score update for Brunswick, 39. For Motive, 33. Sean Rash, can he get more than 39 out of this Hall of Fame judging panel? We'll see what he's got. Kimberly, you've got him.
I sure do. Sean, so you got to beat 39. They were just talking about it over there in the booth. Why don't you tell us what's in your bag of tricks to see if you can do that?
Well, I don't know how Tommy got 39 from that group over there. I mean, he bowled with them for a lot longer than I have. But they're, I mean, look at them. You've got Walter Ray, Parker Bone, Mike Golby, Norm Duke, and Pete Weber, five of the greatest players the game's ever seen. So let's give them a round of applause. Those guys have paved the way for myself and everybody that's up here, but I don't have any money to bribe them. I went to the casino last week and lost a lot, so sorry, honey. At least I didn't go buy any diapers.
So are you trying to suck up to the judges before you go?
No.
No?
One of them probably hates me. One of them doesn't talk to me anymore. One of them I bowled doubles with once. He withdrew. I was on staff with one guy. I mean, it is what it is.
All right, let's get to it.
All right, so an ambitious game plan for Sean Rash. The reviews are in. First things first is a mix of analysis, tremendous chemistry, and total ridiculousness. Nick Wright, Chris Broussard, and Kevin Wilde serve up a fresh daily dose of unscripted and unfiltered sports talk. Weekdays at 3 p.m. Eastern on FS1.
Come on, Sean Rash!
Now, we both saw Sean in warm-ups make the two-ball trick with the big four.
Walter Ray can do it with one ball.
I knew you were going to say that. Wow, one for one.
Hey, Walter Ray. Yeah, that was pretty cool. He made it with two balls, but you made it with one. How impressed are you with this opening shot?
Well, he did it one for one. That's pretty good.
Not bad.
And this satisfying moment of the match is sponsored by Snickers. Nothing satisfies like a Snickers.
Yeah.
Well, that's a pretty good start for Sean. I think that's got to take a little heat off of whatever this is going to be. One more time. He's not going to double dip on this one. Now, yeah, he had a chair out earlier.
Yeah, we might still see that. But at least if he shoots this again, he doesn't have to reset it.
Okay, good.
All right, we're back over here again. We're going to try this one more time.
Oh, we're going this way now.
Uh-oh.
Maybe not. Kick it. Yeah, you can help it.
Well, now there's a trick.
Yeah, that's not going to help it.
Hit a little too hard.
Yeah, that's not going to help it.
One. Yeah, one more. One more on each side. Maybe we should go down there.
Oh, yeah. Now that's going to head left.
All right, never mind. We're going to do the chair. We're going to do the chair.
Yeah, that's pretty fast.
Where you want it?
About right there.
Now.
Right here?
Yeah.
That's it?
Can he fit the ball under that chair, you think?
If I don't know.
That's going to be tough. He may have to go over. Sam Cooley tried this unsuccessfully.
Yeah, but Cooley had the chair way farther down the lane. Wait, what's he doing?
Oh, between the legs and wide left
and the whiff.
Yeah, I'm gonna move out the way.
Yeah.
All right, now he's on the lane with a chair. What's the plan? I guess he's got to go over. Oh, hey, I like that, Sean.
That would've been good.
That wasn't bad. That wasn't bad. Okay, at least he got to the chair without hitting the car over here. No car.
Yeah, between the legs,
better ball. No.
This is not impressing anybody on the panel.
Well, he got off to a fabulous start. He hit his first one.
Yeah, but
the two ball trick on the big four, but he has not hit since. Under 2.5 minutes. This is the guy that Norm thought might do it.
Oh, my goodness, Norm! Norm, what is going on? Norm, what is going on out there?
See, it's carnage, Randy. Just carnage.
Oh, pure carnage. Another gutter ball.
Big 2 minutes.
Instant carnage.
Here we go.
All right, let's try this again. Maybe.
At what point, we're here at Phoenix Raceway, right?
Yeah.
At what point does the caution flag come out?
Oh, my. I'm not saying that. Well, you got to be cautious with that. So look at that.
Uh-oh. It's getting better.
Uh-oh. Back to back.
Over.
Mike Albee, we got off to a great start here with Sean. Then things quieted down pretty quick. And they're picking back up. What do you think?
Oh boy, he's building quickly. Building quickly. There's a lot of excitement down here. I think one more. If he can pull one more trick, I think he's
one
there.
One more,
I think.
More shots, more points.
Gonna go over again. About a minute left. Crush. No drive, no five.
Dude, this feels like it's taking forever. It's getting tired.
Move the chair.
All right, son. That's not good.
I gotta get over here.
I would lose that one out of my repertoire.
Yeah, it's not working. He's got a much better shot going either in the middle or over the chair.
But I think he's made more trick shots than anyone today. And there's another good one.
Tap 10.
I mean, I think you gotta give it to Sean.
He's got 30 seconds. I think at this point, 39 is the number he has to beat.
Take the chair off.
He's not giving up on that trick.
I don't know. I mean,
he's going to keep asking that one to dance.
My good leg.
Nope.
Yeah, he's having about as much success as I did in high school asking people to dance.
He's no quitter.
There we go. Way at the buzzer. A Sean Ranch buzzer beater.
Let's see, everybody together.
He made more than anybody else, who shot way more than everybody.
Yeah. Right. What would you get? What would you get?
You know, there were some pretty good shots in there, but he missed a lot.
A lot of misses, but he had the most makes and the most misses. He kept going, though.
Comparatively speaking, compared to the other two, though.
Yeah, he made
more. For this competition, not compared to all you guys.
All right, judges. Judges, what do you think?
I'm not...
Walter Ray with eight.
Okay.
Parker Bone, eight.
Seven for Pete.
Norm. Seven for Pete. Eight for Mike.
It's a
eight
tie.
For Norm. It's a tie. One trick roll-off between the two players.
All right, well, Sean has gone two hands the big four. He's gone through a chair, over a chair, between the legs. I'm not sure what more he could have done, Kimberly. And frankly, I think the judges may have shortchanged him.
Dave, I was thinking the exact same thing. So why don't we just go ahead and ask Sean, is there anything that you are thinking right now about the judges and how it was judged?
I got no comment.
Do you feel you were robbed?
No, not at all. I mean, Tommy made a good one. I think he only made one.
He made two.
How many times?
And I think you made five, right?
Yeah, five is normally better than two. That's how I look at math. They got an oxygen tank here? Whew. I'm tired. I think Tommy left. Hopefully they called him. I think he had a flight to catch. I don't know.
Yep.
Yeah. Is he here?
Oh, he's here. He's over there in the wings. Done, but are you ready for a roll-off?
I'd like a drink.
You got more work to do before that drink.
Okay. All right.
All right, stepping back into the ring. Tommy Jones of Brunswick. Tie break. It's going to be a very simple tie break. Both Sean and Tommy, Team Storm and Team Brunswick, will be shooting at the Flying Eagle. They get one crack at it. If they do not execute the crack, and we are still tied, or if they both make it, and we're still tied, then they are going to take each of them. We're going to take a bowling pin and chuck it at a full rack. And whoever knocks down the most will capture the 25 points for their team. Sean going first. Has a chance.
Yes!
He's right.
Wow.
Well, so Randy, in 25 years of announcing on the PBA, have you ever said, well, all he has to do to tie is make the Flying Eagle?
Yeah, no. I wasn't going to pick him to win this because Tommy had a few shots at it. And then Sean steps up there and makes it like it was nothing.
Tommy Jones must make the Flying Eagle to extend the roll-off.
Come on, teams.
Come on, Tommy.
Throwing one shot in a little while, Norm. Is this what it feels like to bowl?
Are you kidding me? Oh, my Lord.
Pretty good effort there by Tommy Jones. Cut it in front.
Incredible effort by Tommy Jones. So it's a sweep for Team Storm. They take all three events, the strike competition, the make that spare, and also the trick shot competition. Storm with a perfect score of 75 points. Brunswick second, Motive in third.
What do you think? Take one more look here at Sean Rash and the Flying Eagle. Pretty good stuff there.
And Kimberly standing by with the winning team.
Well, Storm was able to sweep that. Sean, can we talk about the Flying Eagle real quick? Did you think you were going to make that?
I did. You know, I got a couple practice shots. I was pretty close in the second one. What a hell of a team effort, though. You know, Kyle got us off starting with the strikes. Darren made all them spares that we shoot almost every week because we're on the bottom of the list. And then somehow I made a bunch of trick shots.
He's good at playing up 10.
These two were like off their chairs as soon as you made that. But this competition was pretty cool because it really showcased so many different types of, you know, spares and strikes and trick shots. What would you say was the best part of today for your team?
The team win, obviously. That's the best part. It's always the best part.
Obviously. And Kyle, what do you think when you started today? Did you actually think you guys were going to sweep everybody out here?
I didn't think we were going to sweep. I knew we had a good chance just because Darren's a great spare shooter. Sean's been messing around in the bowling center doing tricks probably his whole life, and I know I can throw a few strikes. So it's great to get the win for Team Storm and for Bill Christman as well.
All right. Well, congratulations, Team Storm, taking the win today.
Pretty well.
And they honor the founder of Team Storm, of course, the great and the late great Bill Christman, a tremendous, tremendous man in the history of this sport. Tomorrow, the PBA Legacy Cup is our All-Star Weekend. Coverage continues at FS1, 1 Eastern. Legends and Rising Stars will conclude on Sunday at 1 Eastern on Fox, the PBA NASCAR Invitational here at Phoenix Raceway. Coming up next, Big East Tournament coverage. Hope you've enjoyed this one. For Randy Peterson, Kimberly Pressler, and our entire crew, I'm Dave Lamont. You have been watching the PBA on FS1.